Guys, we want to look at the morphology for pyogenic osteomyelitis in this video, correct? So, depending on the duration, it could be an acute, subacute or a chronic osteomyelitis. And the pathologic changes in any stage are going to be something like suppuration, ischemic necrosis, healing by fibroids and bony repair, okay? So, what and all will be there? Let's look at this. Suppuration, ischemic necrosis, healing by fibrosis, bony repair, right? Ischemic. Look at the spelling. I-S-C-H-E-M-I-C. Chemic. Ischemic necrosis. Okay. Now, what exactly happens? Do you remember this diagram where they are showing you the nutrient artery enters via the nutrient foramen and then it goes and becomes this kind of a hairpin bends here. These are the metaphyseal arteries. So what happens? There's hematogenous spread of the bacteria, let's say. Now the bacteria, because of the hematogenous spread, it reaches via the blood. It comes to these metaphyseal arteries. So here, because of this hairpin bend kind of a thing, the bacteria finds this place to be very convenient, you know, very comfortable and whatever you say, that they are finding this place good to thrive. So the infection begins in the bone, the infection begins at the metaphyseal end of the bone, of the marrow cavity. So you can see where we are. We are in the bone marrow, the metaphyseal end of the marrow cavity. And here what will happen? There will be pus. So suppuration will be there. Suppuration. Okay. So there will be pus in the metaphyseal end of the marrow cavity. Okay. At this stage, when you check the bone, the microscopy will reveal what? Congestion, edema, and lot of neutrophils, because it is going to be an infection, correct? Infection. Then what happens? Let's see. The tension in the marrow cavity is increased due to pus. Okay, this is the second thing they are telling. So what happens? The tension in the marrow cavity will increase, okay, because of the pus. Now what will happen? The infection will start spreading along the marrow cavity into the endosteum and then into the Haversian and Volkmann canal, causing periosteitis. Okay, periosteitis. So actually, let us understand this clearly. See, here the pus was there initially. Now what happens? The pus started filling the marrow cavity. Now it reached the endosteum. Endosteum is here, you remember? Periosteum, then compact bone, then endosteum, then bone marrow, correct? The medullary cavity, correct? Medullary cavity. You remember the diagram, we hope. Otherwise, you have to go back and read the bone structure. Anyways, wait. Just in case you're coming to this video directly, just look at this one, okay? Periosteum, from outside. Periosteum, compact sharpie fibers, then compact bone, then endosteum, then inside medullary cavity, which was filled with red bone marrow in children and yellow in adults, okay? Going back. So, where are we now? So, the marrow got filled with pus. Once the marrow got filled with pus and the tension here has increased in the marrow cavity, the infection has spread to the endosteum. Now from the endosteum, then now it has shifted to the compact bone. Compact bone has what? Haversian canal and Volkmann canal. Now it has affected the Haversian and the Volkmann system, and then it has also affected the periosteum. It is called as periosteitis. Okay. Good now. Second step over. Now third step, guys. Wake up. Third step. We have finished the first step where the infection began at the metaphyseal end. Then the second step, the endosteum is affected, the Haversian and the Volkmann canal are affected. Then now there is something called as periosteitis. Now let us see what happens. Continuing with the third point. The infection may reach the subperiosteal space, forming the subperiosteal abscess. Okay, so there's going to be a subperiosteal abscess. Okay. Let's put that here. Suppuration. Metaphyseal end of marrow cavity. This is point one, okay? Point one, this is. Metaphyseal end of marrow cavity will have pus. Okay? The hairpin bend and all that you can explain. Then tension in marrow cavity increases. Spread of infection to endosteum. Endosteum is affected. Then Haversian canal. Wolfman canal are affected. Then, what are affected, guys? Wolfman canal is affected. This will lead to periosteitis. Then, subperiosteal abscess is formed. And sinus to skin. Okay? Draining skin sinus tracts. Okay? It will penetrate the cortex. And draining skin sinus tracts. Okay? Combination of suppuration and impaired blood supply to the cortical bone results in erosion, thinning and infarction necrosis of the cortex called sequestrum. Sequestrum is formed. This is nothing but the infarction necrosis of the cortex. Okay. Infarction necrosis of the cortex. Sequestrum. So, what happens? Because of what and all? Suppuration and impaired blood supply. Because of impaired blood supply to the bone and because of pus existence there, the cortex undergoes necrosis and this thing is called as sequestrum. This word is important. They have asked sequestrum in the exam. Okay. Now here you should say the cortex will be eroded and thin. Okay. Now, let's move on to point 5 according to the textbook, the formation of involucrum.